yeah, to what you guys were saying with this game, primarily, I want to try bring it back a little bit. It was one of those things where, like I said in the beginning, but it couldn't be heard. It was one of those games where it just felt like the Knicks were, we knew that they were missing their best players, and we kind of were playing to that level a little bit. Like, it was a little sloppy in the beginning. Both teams were playing defense. We had a nice little lead, but at the same time, we were a little lacking on the defensive end. But then we were able to bring it back together. The half, and I wasn't a big fan of how the half ended. We played better in the second quarter, but I wasn't a big fan of how the half ended. But like Alex said, man, that third quarter is something that we saw a lot more this year compared to, you know, Knicks games in the past. We saw a third quarter where it was well put together. You know, we had the starting unit play really well, and then we were able to mesh the bench in right with those guys. You know, it's what we've been asking for. You know, there'd be instances where the starters just don't look good in the third, and we want the bench to come in sooner, but they meshed in really well to the point where Thibodeau was able to bring one at a time. Like, okay, we'll take out RJ for Derrick Rose and so on and so forth, to the point where we had the full bench for the fourth. So I thought this was a good game. It was just funny how the referees just they put on their Lakers jerseys in that second half for whatever reason, started giving us some reckless calls. But all in all, I'm happy with this win. You know, being in LA, I'm hearing all the Laker fans talking about, yeah, y'all lucky because we didn't have AD in this. I don't care who you didn't have. We were 500. We need to be back over 500. So I'm glad we took this win and we did what we had to do. So.
And also, like, you're lucky they didn't have AD. And I mean, the Nets lost and they didn't have AD and LeBron. Tell them. So
right.
The other team across the bridge, because I know my mic went out the last 14 seconds of what I said, but what I said was, and I'll repeat, was I hope that the other team across the bridge was taking notes, because that's how the real team in New York goes ahead and beats the Los Angeles Lakers without LeBron James and Anthony Davis. So, and I know people want to say, well, Kuzma was out there. Kuzma's a non-factor. Let's get that out of the way.
Yeah.
Okay. You had two superstars that were missing from the court when you played them, and you had your superstar on Kevin Durant. You had half the time with Kyrie Irving, you still couldn't pull out a win. But you know why the Knicks did? Because one, we play defense, and two, we're the real kings in New York. So respect us. That's all I got.
Tell them. That's what I'm saying. You had your nice little game against Brooklyn, and they came in here thinking that it was going to be simple. Nah, it wasn't. It ain't that way. We talking our talk. But yeah, we got. I know Ashley tried to skim past it, but we got to talk about this box score real quick. We got to talk about it. I mean, you know, we give him such a hard time. I mean, most of the time it is warranted, but Elfrid Payton, he did the thing tonight, man. And although I'm one that I, especially, you know, looking at a lot of his highlights from last year, and my biggest thing with him, I just wish he would go back to being a ball, you know, a facilitator. That's all I'm asking for. I'm not asking for too much. Elfrid Payton is a solid facilitator. That's probably one of the big positives that he's had in his entire career. 7 assists last year, this year, not so much. But outside of that, you know, seeing him go out there and drop, how many points, Ashley Moss? I just want you to say out loud how many points Elfrid Payton had.
Was it 20?
Yeah, 20 points. Uh huh. Uh huh. And Alpha, what was that? What was that? Those splits looking like? Alex, what was his field goal looking like?
9 for 12.
Yeah, we just got to do this together. Like we all got to rip this Band-Aid off. In no way, shape, or form am I here, you know, as the Elfrid Payton apologist. But at the same time, we all just, you know, we got to just kumbaya and just, you know, we got to give Elfrid Payton his you know, his little star, golden star. You did it. Good job, bro. Congratulations. But
you did it tonight. Here's the thing. It's the same kind of critique that I had with Frank when we were having this conversation earlier in the season.
Right.
No one's discrediting that Payton can do it. That's not the issue. It's he doesn't do it consistently enough
right. For
it to be something to brag about. Because what I'm getting from him tonight, or what I got from him tonight, I'm not going to get from him again on what is it, Tuesday, the next game?
Wednesday.
Next game this week, Wednesday. I'm not going to get that from him on Wednesday. So, and if I do, I'm not going to get it from him the following game. It's just very inconsistent. Like I said, that's why I compare him to the ex who knows you're about to move on, and he texts you just to make sure you're still in arm's reach, because it's almost like he has like these spidey senses that the franchise, or the fans of the franchise rather, are like fed up with him. He's like, oh, well, gotta go out there and do something. It's just not part of his pedigree. It's not consistent enough for me to brag about it. That's all. I mean, shout out to him. Appreciate it. We got the dub, so great game. But I need to see it more to brag about it.
I think that's fair. Alex, what you gonna give him any love? How are you feeling about Elfrid Payton?
I mean, for Payton, like, he played a solid game tonight. I mean, more often than not, to Ashley's point, he's not on, right?
Right.
I'll give him this, though. For two games in a row, he shot well for two games in a row. Yesterday, went 5 for 7. Had his, what was it, I think 11 points yesterday. Now he had 20 points on 9 for 12. So he was through two games, he shot the ball pretty well just by doing what he does best, which is attacking the lane and finishing around the rim when he gets it going. But for the most part, how can you, like, I get where everyone's coming from with the sentiment. They want Thibodeau to start Emmanuel quickly or Derrick Rose. And the issue is that we have very few point guards. Tibbs doesn't trust quickly enough to put him in the starting rotation. Mm-hmm. I'd like to see quickly get more minutes. I'd like to see Derrick Rose starting as well. But as of right now, he's going to use Payton because we see Derrick Rose has his 25 to 27 minute cap. So he has to go somewhere else to figure it out. We've seen Alec Burks in there, but in a game like this, I guess you could have gotten Alec Burks to close it off, right? Yeah. Payton just had it going. So Tibbs was like, hey, he's got it going. Got to go finish with him. But we've seen him finish with Burks too. And I guess the concern with Burks is, you know, his tendency to turn over the ball when it gets into crunch time, right? But at the same time, Payton did the same thing against Minnesota. So it's hard with the point guard position right now. Tibbs is going to use whatever he has at this point. And, you know, it's so tough, man. I mean, we get on it all the time. It's just kind of a broken record at this point, but I get it.
And to that point, like, yes, and I want people to know I'm giving – Payton his credit. He had a great game tonight. It's just, it's weird to me because it's like when we talk about IQ, one of the criticisms from Tibbs or when they asked him, you know, earlier on in the season why he wasn't starting him, it was because of the lack of consistency, that he wanted to see more from him. But Payton has the same lack of consistency, but he's held to a different standard by Tibbs. And that's the frustrating part of it. All because right. If you look at it, they're both up and down just in different ways. And if you're going to, if what's good for the goose has to be good for the gander, you know what I mean? So it, that's what's frustrating to me. It's because it's like Payton gets a different set of rules for performing the same way in terms of inconsistencies and this topsy-turvy roller coaster performances that we get from him. And it's just not fair. And that's not taking away from what he did tonight. Like I said, you helped to secure a win for your team. That's what you're on the court for. That's what you get paid for. But to go as far and saying like, oh, keep Payton have this. It's not enough for me to get on that train because it's so inconsistent. And if he's going to be held to a different standard, or rather if his teammates are held to a different standard for their inconsistencies, Payton has to be held to the same standard. That just is what it is.
Yeah, no, I'm 100% playing devil's advocate here because I completely agree. You know, I'm proud of it. It was a good night tonight. Like I said, the biggest thing for me is the fact that he took 12 shots and he actually had more points than shots. So I'm proud of that. But yeah, to both of you guys' point, the big thing here is it's like you can have those kind of stats tonight. Cool. But how's it going to look on Wednesday, like Ashley said? Like, that's my thing. It's got to be consistent because I don't know. I mean, we're playing the Pelicans, so it might be similar. Because, you know, their interior defense is but their defense at all is not that great. So it might be a similar night, but let's see how he takes advantage of that. I think that's a wait and see kind of thing. But regardless, whether we like it or not, ladies and gentlemen, Elfrid Payton, he was a big part of tonight's win because RJ Barrett was not all there for us tonight. You know, he still, like we say all the time, RJ Barrett still did a lot of good. You know, there's good things, you know, but again, if it's the Obi Toppin effect where it's like you're giving him a golden star for playing basketball on an NBA team, he wasn't great tonight. You know, only having what was it 4 points? Did he get Pat? I'm sorry. What did RJ have? RJ had 7 points. 7 points. Excuse me. On a rough night, still was a plus 18. 2 for 11. But you know, he's gonna have one of those games, especially off of that stretch he was having. You know, it's okay. He's human. It's a lot to come. But I'm trying to say this because I know we're going to have some people saying, there you go to RJ Barrett. He cooled down. Told you he was going to stay out forever. Like, people won't look for anything right now when it comes to RJ Barrett. But Angel, what's good, bro? How you feeling, man?
Yo, what's going on, CK2K? How's everybody doing?
Hi.
We're good, bro. We're good. How you feeling?
My man, Alex. What's up, bro? And to the queen, mi amor, mi esposa, ¿cómo está? How you doing, Ash?
What's going on?
Smooth.
I am doing great. Yeah, my mom calling me Smooth, man. I went to go see her after surgery, and she was like, "Hey, Smooth," and I'm just like, "Ah, oh, man, here it goes." So it definitely has grown in on me. But you know, I wish you was there yesterday, because you know I am officially the GOAT simp. So I would like to see some GOAT simps in the chat. I would like to see that. I gotta be honest. First things first, man. Hit that thumbs up for your boys, man. Stop playing. Hit that thumbs up. And I actually look great. I just gotta throw that in there as well. But you know, first thing first, man. When it comes to the game, just the defense, bro. I mean, we caused 25 turnovers. You know, we had 9 blocks, 14 steals, and that just really set the tone for the whole game. Obviously, you know, the Lakers don't have their superstars, but listen, you know, we didn't have Mitch, you know, and in the end, you know, a win is a win. You know, you're not going to be able to, you know, play perfect every game, but you know what? You know, you got to grind it out. And I really thought Julius Randle, Broadway Bully, you know, he really stepped his game up with 34 points, 10 rebounds. You know, he was shooting 50% from the field, and his shot was on today. So that was really encouraging to see. And, you know, I hate to admit it, but Elfrid Payton, you know, he played really well today, you know, and I'm still starting the GoFundMe account. Ashley Mino, we talked about this, you know, I'm still starting that GoFundMe account. I do not want to see this dude on the team next year, but, you know, he really did step his game up today with 20 points, 9 of 12 from the field. And, you know, he was really aggressive and, you know, Derrick Rose, I thought he was efficient coming off the bench as well. And, you know, the fact that right now we're a game over 500, we're 15-0 at home when leading at the three quarters, you know, that's very impressive. And I thought, you know, when the Lakers made that little run, you know, Julius and would just kind of close the deal. And, you know, it's a win is a win, you know, and I'm real happy, you know, we got the Pelicans coming up. You know, we got some winnable games, man. I'm excited, but, you know, we're just going to take it one game at a time. And, you know, thanks for taking my call, guys. I really appreciate it, man.
Yeah, man. Got to have you, man. Appreciate you, Angel. Thank you so much, man. Yeah, no, I agree. Like he said, and like we were saying, you know, defense was definitely one of the big keys. And I'm going to make sure that's going to be one of the prereqs for everybody calling in tonight. I'm going to make everybody mention Elfrid Payton and his stat line in some capacity. Man. I'm doing it. I'm gonna do it. They gotta come in. You gotta be like, okay, cool. What did Elfrid have tonight? And they gonna have to say 20 points or something. I'm doing it. I'm telling you. You're gonna give some respect to him today.
I think though that Angel had a good point, and I want to look at the next couple of games that are coming up. Mm-hmm. You know, obviously the Pelicans, that's a winnable game. I want to look at the remaining schedule, and we can obviously break down what we can expect from those games, but. It is important, you know, you got some of the tougher games out of the way so far. Obviously, it's important to see what other games are remaining in the season. So I don't know if CK or Alex, you guys can pull that up. But it's important. You know, every game counts at this point. This is the final stretch. You know, if this was a mile, this would be the last lap around the track. And every game matters, especially if you're trying to obtain any spot between that 4 and 6. So obviously Wednesday night's game matters. We caught a break playing the Lakers without LeBron and Anthony Davis, because otherwise that probably would not have been a good time.
Man, Mike, how are you feeling, bro? What's up?
Mad love to the three of y'all. Mad love to everyone else, Knicks, everybody else, Knicks Nation. Listen, I know you're going to think I'm crazy.
Uh-oh.
But I feel like the Knicks showing out with our defense this season is going to get Kawhi Leonard.
Oh.
It's going to get Kawhi Leonard.
He said it.
I mean, I'm hearing talks about he wants to go to Miami and all that extra stuff, and I'm thinking, like, nah. This young New York Knicks team, if he came here, he knows here, I think the whole league knows that we just missing one piece. Look at how many games we lost by, like, a bucket. I think a lot of people are watching. He knows he would be the difference maker. We get him, we get a point guard, it's a wrap. I think he's going to put us in a similar situation as LA. He's going to be like, yo, if you could get PG, I'll go. So he's going to tell us what point guard he wants here, and we're going to get him. He's going to come. I'm not crazy. You heard it here first.
I'm not crazy. All right, Mike. Look, man.
Hey, word.
Yeah, you said the word. Like, I've been tiptoeing around it. I'm saying it's too early, but you just going all in and you're saying it's going to happen. You're all in on it. You're not going to back down from
using
it, right?
The powers of manifestation.
That's two of them tonight. Right. I ain't mad at it.
We're going for it.
I'm mad at Mike at all. Appreciate
it. It's a spirit bomb, and we all gonna put a little bit in it.
We all put a little in it. Oh, I like the reference. Okay. All right. I'll put a little bit.
That in the manifestation.
Have a good night.
Along with, you know, me getting that series against Brooklyn and winning. Put that in the manifestation.
Look, man, I love both of those. I would be a big fan of us taking out Brooklyn in that first round. I'd be an even bigger fan of us getting Kawhi Leonard to add to this group. But then that other conversation we just had about Julius Randle changes a little bit. But I'm not.
We're I thought we weren't tonight. Saying the K word, though.
I'm gonna say his name. But at the same time, I'm not gonna say that sentence of the Knicks are gonna get. I'm not ready for that. Kawhi. Kawhi not, Ashley. Kawhi not. But
Trust me, bro.
But other than that, yeah.
Sources, me.
Yeah, right. Sources, and he adds himself. But other than that, like, yeah, no, I mean, it's a conversation that is going to be had. But Mike is over here trying to jump the gun, and he's gonna try. He has all right to be, if it becomes serious, to say, you know, I said it first, Mike. We with you, bro. I got the name saved here. I got you ready for, you know, if that conversation becomes real. I think it's not completely far fetched for that to happen. I'm not gonna co-sign it yet, but I don't think it's out of the cards. I think it's kind of weird that there has been no conversation on them. Maybe there is behind the scenes on him and the Clippers on a new deal and re-signing and moving forward. I don't know. There's just, you know, anything could happen. The Clippers collapse again in the playoffs. Who knows? You know?